Come on.
All right, boy. Come on, boy.
Get the hell away.
Here. Yeah.
Do anything. I'm going to take a few photographs. Come on. Come on. Don't mean to be rude, but you're blocking my shot of the bait. You're kind of in the way there. Thank you. not really looking for a shot of you. So if you could move a smidge.
You don't know me very well.
Well, to me, you're a gentleman.
Usually. I'm worse than the wolves.
You had many dealings with wolves, Mr. Morgan?
Your team writes to...
Yes, yes, there they are. In the trees. Now, don't do anything. I'm going to take a few photographs. Come on. Come on.
They ain't provoked, they're just wolves.
Just a fucking help!
Hound of hell? Oh, now I've got an eight! Hey, is that all of them? We might have kept the wolves from the door.
Futile existence flashed before my eyes.
Yeah, they can be pretty aggressive.
What a way to... Literally a dog's dinner. Still worse things happen at sea?
Do they?
Well, I imagine. I was just checking this equipment, if only my hands weren't shaking quite so much. The only trophy I need is a photograph, and I hope it catches on. I'll be some time working on the mechanism. Good day to you, sir, and Godspeed. Doesn't strike in the same place, and neither do wolves. You're a collector of pelts. I hope only in cases of self-defense. Thank you again. Fare thee well.
Yep.
Here.
Pretty good hunt there, boy.
Yep.
There you go. Yep. Yeah.
can't turn me in! This ain't just!
Son of a bitch, kill him! That horse
You couldn't leave it alone!
Beat those sons of bitches!
You are one dead fat!
Hey! Could you get me off this damn nag? Please don't leave me on here! Come on, man, cut the ropes off! Oh, boy, I sure owe you one. If I'm gonna be hanged, at least let it be for a crime I committed.
Yeah. Yep. Easy now.
Hey, you should think twice before you come up on someone that's done.
Yep. Yep. Giddy up. Easy. Okay, boy. Yeah. That's it.
We found them, boys. Put them hands up before I make you. You got mush for brains? Last time I tell you, hands up. I had enough of this. Put them down.
Damn it!
Okay, boy. Let's go.
Yep.
morning, Arthur.
That'll do it, boy. Good morning, Arthur.
Oh, say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna kill you.
You come near me, sailor, and I'll slice you up.
You put that knife down or you could be missing a hand.
What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. Was there insufficient feathers in your pillow?
I ain't lazy, Mr. Morgan. I'll work, but not this.
Well, I ain't cooking. You cool down then yet?
I guess. But I ain't no scullion. And I sure as hell ain't taking orders from that sweating halfwit.
I guess we all gotta do our share, Princess.
Where's the letter?
Are you reading his mail now?
Oh, robbing and killing's okay, but letter reading's where we draw the line.
Mm. Here.
Dear Aunt Kathy.
You are something else.
I haven't heard from you in some time, so I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah. It's boring. Ooh! Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself.
Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. You ever actually even talked to a woman he ain't paid for?
Oh, look, we're all hiding behind something.
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, that. Now that's Dutch's idea. All mail to be sent to the same alias. Whenever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Tells him to start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got work to do. Okay, here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you...
No! You insane?
I thought we was outlaws.
Outlaws, not idiots. We rob fools that rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy some food to eat. And no guns.
You're sure?
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting.
What did you get there, Harold?
Nothing.
Sir, good morning.
Money to be made on the...
Can I help you, mister?
Yes, I would like to post a letter.
All right. Okay, no trouble.
Thank you.
Bye now.
I'm trying.
Try harder.
Hear that moonshine operation out in the swamp over from LaGrasse got blown to high hell.
They're saying that.
I think this is everything.
Thanks. Here. Take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
We'll give it back then. Jesus. I didn't ask for his goddamn help.
Why don't you drive?
Okay.
Come on, lady, get a move on.
I like Sadie, not lady.
I know. So, you get everything?
I think so.
And some new clothes, I see?
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
I'll have you know, I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you, know. Maybe I'll keep my eye out for another one.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know nobody's taking nothing from me ever again.
Mm-hmm. Just don't kill the camp cook. Please.
Hey there!
Hey.
What you folks up to?
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool, Steve.
You need to pay a toll to pass through here.
Oh, I don't think so.
You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this? Ah! Go, go, go!
Shit!
think you're landing records.
I'm gonna run this son of a bitch down.
This woman needs to get shot.
Well, you wanted to see some action, lady. Now you've got your wish.
Shit.
You okay there, Sage? Pass those reins here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine. We showed those bastards, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
You did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks, but maybe not.
Careful! So who did they say they were? Lemoyne Raiders?
Yeah, I've run into them before. Some local gang. Don't seem to have grown out of playing soldiers. Anyway, won't you go upsetting Pearson about that letter?
How dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Right, you wouldn't.
I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself.
I won't be giving you no mail to post anytime soon, that's for sure.
I just want a peek in that journal of yours. The mind boggles.
You didn't get yourself killed then, Miss Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversations, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
Oh, shut up.
I don't understand that lawman getup.
Hi there, Arthur.
A stew without good meat is no stew at all, Mr. Morgan.
Fine, but make sure you get a good price for it. Sure, might as well make some money off it.
Good job, Arthur. Thank you, Arthur. Oh, Mr. Morgan, I've jotted down a few things that I think could be nice additions around here.
Sing for our supper, miss. Sure, and singing's fine, but I'm done with that. And if you want me to leave, then that's fine, too.
Well, I suppose... At least I still give a
Dutch?
Damn.
Do whatever you got, Dingham, please.
You don't give a damn.
I dance above her station. You think we don't know her station?
Dutch will see through you soon enough.
I'll see to that.
Arthur!
The Boy Scouts will be very pleased.
Guess we'll see if anyone notices.
Mary Beth?
John?
All right. I'll see you later.
Okay, Reverend.
Uncle.
Say, Morgan. Morgan, you got any hair pomade?
Come on, boy. What are you doing?
Going fishing. The river's around here. There's a spot not too far from here that I've been wanting to try out.
Glad you're so excited about this.
You will be too when you start pulling out smallmouth. Okay, follow me.
I thought you said it wasn't far.
Too far to walk.
Dog.
Yeah, come on. Gib! Whoa!
Since we rode out, just you and me.
Probably since we went looking for John on the mountain.
Yeah. Already seems long ago. How you feeling about everything? Been a strange couple of months.
Hey, you know, I can't even return to my country because the price on my head is so big. This? This is nothing exactly new to me. And I'll always be loyal to Dutch. He sees the world the same... Hey, come on, enough of that. He sees the world the same as I. If we have to fight, we fight. Hurry up! Wait, this isn't the right way. Why are you riding off like that? Now, as I was saying, if we have to run, we'll run. If we must die, what are you trying to kill now? If we must die, we'll die, but we'll stay free. Hey, what are you doing? Stop messing around and let's go.
And Dutch, you don't feel like, well, that he's doing things a little differently now? You saw what happened with that girl on the ferry.
No fight, good or bad, is won without blood. I know that better than most. I think too many people are focusing on Dutch when they should be looking at themselves, what they could have done better.
Maybe you're right.
We'll cut through to the right here. The other day, I rode down to the Lanahatchee River. I caught some beautiful steelhead trout.
You mean the Lanahatchee River?
No. The Lanahatchee. It runs right near here.
Yeah, but it's pronounced Lanahatchee.
Why is everything in English said differently than it's written? Make us feel stupid?
Oh, you're asking the wrong feller.
Okay, it's just down the hill here.
Whoa!
Arthur! Okay, come on. Let's go try our luck. Pretty country.
Beautiful.
Come on, let's go see what's biting. You take this spot, Arthur. I'm going to cast from over to the right there, so... we're not in each other's way. time of day really can make a difference. They feed early morning or late evening, because that's when the insects are more likely to be out. We're lucky we got such nice weather, but rain can be good. Sometimes big fish think the raindrops are insects.
Well, I guess it's still relaxing, even if I don't catch anything. Sort of like staring at the sky.
He's a fighter. Trick is, let him... tire himself out. Look at that. That's a good-looking fish.
Well done.
Okay, let's try for another. You got one! Make sure he's tired before you reel in. Another one. This is an angry one. He's small, but might make a nice meal.
Oh, keeping you.
It's getting close to nightfall. Fish will stop feeding soon. Let's catch a couple more and then head back. My bag is getting full. Another one. Come on. Look at that. That's a good-looking fish.
Well done.
I was thinking, you remember that stagecoach we held up in Nevada?
Yeah. It was a tip from that crooked lawman in Reno.
We open the door and it's full of women and children. Rich. Oh. Women and children. So we let it go and read in the newspaper that the O'Driscolls robbed and killed them all the next day further down the trail.
Yep. You know, way back in the day, Tom O'Driscoll and Dutch were sort of friends.
Friends?
Well, not friends, but they had an understanding. Then Combs Mean Streak. Got meaner and Dutch. Dutch wanted to try to live a different way.
And now, here we are. You want everyone to know we're coming? He's a fighter. Trick is, let him tire himself out. I was thinking, you remember that stagecoach we held up in Nevada?
Yeah. It was a tip from that crooked lawman in Reno.
We open the door and it's full of women and children. Rich, but women and children. So we let it go and read in the newspaper that the O'Driscolls robbed and killed them all the next day further down the trail.
Yep. You know, way back in the day, Home O'Driscoll and Dutch were sort of friends.
Friends?
Well, not friends, but they had an understanding. Then Combs Mean Street got meaner, and Dutch wanted to try to live a different way.
And now, here we are. Another one. This is an angry one. Look at that. That's a good-looking fish.
Well done.
There you go, Arthur. Okay, let's try for another. Don't rush it, Arthur. Another one. Come on. He's small, but might make a nice meal.
Oh, keeping you.
It's getting close to nightfall. Fish will stop feeding soon. Let's catch a couple more and then head back. My bag is getting full. Another one. Another one. Pull to the left as he goes right. Too bad. Another one. This is an angry one. I've heard people talk about huge smallmouth in Lake Owenjila, west of Strawberry, over in Big Valley. You'd need a lure to catch one that big, though. You're better than you let on. Slowly. Slowly. Another one. Another one. Come on. Good job, Arthur. Not bad, you see? It's the bait.
It ain't just the bait.
I'm gonna head back. You wanna join me, or you keep trying for these bastards?
Nah, I'll stay.
No problem. I'll see you back there.
I think you've overstayed your welcome.
Relax.
All right, I've had enough. Ow! Go! Don't you stop moving.
Yep. Yep. Thank you.
do you? Hey, mister.
Morning, mister.
Busy day?
Can't help it if y'all slow.
Well, keep at it.
See you around.
Yep.
Only thing I live for. Just let me live this one through, will you?
I'm feeling now.
Shit. I never thought nobody would catch me with that fat lady.
Now, I usually buy candy. So how are you doing?
Nice to see you again, mister. Looking for a special something for a special someone? Beautiful. Just a second.
I won't ask too many questions about its previous ownership.
Oh, this ain't good.
Listen, you end up going St. Denise's way, you don't bother with the shop there. Idiot marks up his prices because the customers there are made of money, you see? I'll say the best things ain't purchased. If you know what I mean. You got anything of value? Don't care for the origin. Thank you.
Giddy up.
Think about laying hands on me again, it's gonna end bloody for you. All right, what do you want?
Okay, now let me see.
Listen, you won't take all day, will you? Thank you.
Line up, Rose. It's your favor.
Sheriff's orders. You wanted me to have a word with some folk on the property. I'm recently deputized, you see.
Deputized? And I suppose Lee was drunk when he did it? Look, you can come in, but you ain't talking with me.
Obliged. You talk?
I look like I can talk. You want to talk or try Bo Gray? How about the store?
Hi there, mister.
Hello.
Morning.
Hello.
Huh. I'll see you at the sheriff's office.
Excuse me, friend.
We friends?
Not yet, but he is hoping.
I guess.
We don't get a lot of traveling men here, and suddenly there's a whole phalanx of mysterious but strangely helpful Yankees about the place.
Is there?
What are you doing here?
I was just looking for work.
Well, looking for something. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
The thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope. But it's impossible.
Well, love tends to be complicated.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, the sheriff, grandson of old Murdo Gray. We Grays have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty and stupidity, I'm supposed to be loyal to some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved. Gang feuds, seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Grays, we've always got money. No brains mind but money.
Well, in that case.
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter and this bracelet, please.
Oh, look out for their guards. They're worse with strangers than ours are. Look out for their guards. They're worse with strangers than ours are.
for it.
Are you Penelope Braithwaite?
Well, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you. Let's go, boy.
chicken cries like a baby. Go down it.
I'll sleep well tonight.
Okay, boy. Yep. You got my money?
Sure. Did she give anything? For me?
Yes.
Might I have it?
Sure. But it'll cost you.
Mount up, all right. And follow me to Rhodes. Come on! Come on! Yeah! We'll go around the property and take the road to town. Ah!
Calm down.
I can't be calm. If we don't get there in time, my true love may be shot.
If she wants to rally, you gotta let her rally.
Well, good as the cause is, I can't let her become a martyr to it. I want to marry a flesh and blood woman, not a statue in her honor.
I'm sure they know what they're doing.
There! There they are!
Bo, what are you doing here?
I cannot let you go through.
Let liberty reign! We're mothers, wives, housekeepers, and daughters. We cook the food and
now,
we fetch
now.
The water.
Take us down Main Street, right through town to the steps of the Bank of Roads, Mr. What was your name?
Arthur Morgan.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Not too quick and not too slow. We need them to hear our voice.
Well, they'll hear it all right.
Very good, very good. Mr. Morgan, are you an old friend of the movement?
I'm just a driver, Mrs. Calhoun. Maybe a shotgun messenger if it comes to it. I hope it won't.
Well, our message will be delivered peaceably, Mr. Morgan. You can keep your shotgun to yourself. Stay on Main Street. It's a left up here, Mr. Morgan. Look at these people. It's about to get exciting. I can feel it.
I believe you might be right.
Good day, Sheriff. I trust you'll make sure it's a peaceful assembly. Oh, do give it a rest, you sorry fool. Mr. Morgan, I give you the mail of the species.
Yeah, that's a pretty dumb specimen, I grant it.
A little further, please. Stop just past the bank. This spot is fine, sir.
Ladies? Get down!
Come on! Come on!
Come on, Bo. Let's go. Quick now.
Follow me. I know a place. It's an old battlefield no one goes to.
America, what a land of the future! A land of equality, a land of progress. Look at the beautiful land we have built.
You don't want to go back and hear the speeches? I ain't voted before, but kind of getting hot for voting rights.
I don't know whether to take you seriously, Mr. Morgan. My cousins are my primary concern right now. If everyone knows about Penelope and me...
Everyone knows about Penelope and you? I know about Penelope and you, and I've been here all of 10 minutes. The sooner it's out, the sooner it's resolved.
The sooner it's dealt with, you mean? We're dealt with. Our families, the Greys and the Braithwaites, we bury our secrets, and we bury them deep.
Your secrets and your treasure.
You know, Catherine Braithwaite's got a daughter. No one's seen her in years. She weren't right, you know, and Penelope said...
I ain't heard about daughters. I heard about gold.
But Yankee gold? I fear that's just a story, Mr. Morgan. But I don't know.
This is awful.
Nobody died. Ain't that awful?
My cousins are vindictive bastards. My brothers are vindictive bastards. My cousins are worse.
They started it.
I know, but...
You should leave.
I will, as soon as I have enough money. When my family... We have money, but I don't.
Is your family very rich?
Yes. Well, I believe so. But, they keep me out of the discussions. I have more of a... artistic temperament, so...
Oh, is that what they call it?
Yes. Oh, you made a joke. Mm. I really love her. I do.
Well, stick around. Maybe you can die for her as well.
I thought you were trying to make me feel better.
Look, I gotta go.
Me too. Oh, damn! I'm gonna be late. My uncle is quite as bad as you would imagine. Here, your payment. Thank you. Excuse me.
Hey, Arthur. Can I have a quick word?
So what? You're a deputy now?
Oh, good, sir.
Mr. Morgan.
Arthur.
What's going on?
Jose and John are looking for you. They went out to the moonshine stash, said you knew where that was. They was planning a visit to the Braithwaite place, but John needs to do something for Dutch now, so Jose wants you to join him instead. Seems to be a lot going on.
You're telling me. Okay, thank you.
Hey, Arthur.
What are you doing?
Selling it.
I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses. And all I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Hello, gentlemen, how are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. She's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please.
What you want?
Found something. Out in the hills. Thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor?
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's ours. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Whoa. Relax, I ain't here to rob you. No, it seems that's easy enough. Why not do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
D- $1 a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
I look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business. All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me. Yeah.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing dress up. You know my feelings about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Isaiah, please.
I'm the clown. You're the brother turned idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward just a bit. Squint. Oh, perfect.
Okay, Fenton, stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so.
Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me.
Gentlemen, quite the town you have here. We just rode in from up north.
Hey.
Hello. Hello, I'm Melvin. This is my brother Fenton. Don't mind him. Don't madden him. He's turned idiot.
Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of yous.
We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour? Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Just hand out the liquor. Gentlemen, my name is Melvin. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy. Now come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas, it's your luck.
I'll have one, Fenton.
Three drinks. A gift. Bounty. It's a sin to look a gift horse in the mouth. When I see a gift horse, I hurt my eyes.
Oh, that's some strong stuff.
Sin won't catch us.
Just keep them coming.
So drink up. Don't be shy, it's the land of opportunity.
Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
Another barrel, Fenton. These men are dry. It's your opportunity to get hideously drunk.
Come Where's on. Mine, then?
Come on. We got work to do, my boys. Let's go. Providence is shining on you.
You're a fine man, Fenton. Come on. Fine man. Come on. Don't listen to your brother.
Fenton.
Over here, Fenton.
Hey!
dumb bastard!
Whoa, wife is gonna kill me? I only went out for milk?
I'll have one, Fenton.
Keep drinking! There's plenty more where that came from, and it's all free!
Well, that hit the spot! Keep them coming, Fenton!
Just keep...
Drink up, drink!
Des Moines Raiders.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Quiet libation.
You.
Me.
You're the bastards who stole the liquor we was gonna buy.
Jump! We're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor!
An honest mistake!
Boys, get him!
I want both those sons of bitches dead! Here's...
Good job, Arthur. You done, you piece of crap!
You think we wouldn't find you?
I want both those sons of bitches dead!
Good job, Arthur.
You shouldn't have crossed the Raiders.
You think we wouldn't find you?
Coming after us.
Ah!
It's more they don't want another gang on their patch.
Okay. Pull off the road here.
All right. We're good.
Yeah. Remind me never to take up a career in... What was it?
Advertising.
Yeah. You think that woman set us up?
No, I don't think so.
So, what do you think?
About what?